ऑल्सो जन्मांतरे मुक्ति हेतु नियमन सो दैट ऑल्सो द मृत्यु कैन बी डायरेक्टली ऑल्सो द मीन्स ऑफ मुक्ति सो दैट इज व्हाट वाज सेड हियर प्रसूदकादि तीर्थेषु तथा च मरणं स्मृतौ श्रूयते मुक्ते साक्षात् सो इन तीर्थासनेस प्रयाग काशी वी हियर दैट दैट द वेरी डेथ इट्सेल्फ इज द कॉज ऑफ मुक्ति न भयम् स्याद् अतो मृते एंड देयरफॉर देयर इज नो भय फ्रॉम डेथ फॉर दिस साधका हु नोज दैट डेथ ऑल्सो इज गोइंग टू सर्व द पर्पस द फास्टिंग एंटिल डेथ ऑल्सो हैज अ ट्रेमेंडस इफेक्ट नॉट जस्ट फास्टिंग But this kind of resolve that I'm going to fast until death, now that is atyanta shuddhikrat. So that will bring about inner purification and bring about vivesha in course of time. And this is how one will attain that perfection. Or if one dies in a given kshetra like Kashi or Prayaga, then the very death also is a cause of mukti. So it is said. I guess the idea must be that when you at the time of death, when you live in a place like Banaras, etc., the very vibrations, whatever, you know, that obtains there, must create an influence upon the person. Although it is said that when someone dies at Kashi, then Lord Shiva himself comes and then recites that Taraka mantra, Hare Rama, in the ears of this dying person, and thus he dies with the bhavana of God, and therefore he attains God. So, this is a very the glory of the place itself that impacts the person so much that he must become free from every other kind of bhavana in the mind and the mind must be filled with this bhavana. It may be there at some point in time when the Kashi was really holy, you know, so it could very well be there. Brahma jnanena mucchyante prayaga maraneena vaityadhyayam api smritau. So brahma jnanena mucchyante. People die, people get liberated with Brahma Jnana and Prayaga Maranenava and also by the mere death in Prayaga. Tathacha Mridikritam Anashakasya Apalatva Visham Bhayamnasti. Therefore, that this mrityu of the death will bring about just a termination of myself that is not so. It also is nothing but a stepping stone towards the further development. So looking at the Tika now in the next verse, Sarvaihya Pitarhi Mukshubhi Anashanam Maranantaram Anushteyam. So when you glorify Maranantam Anashanam, so fasting unto death, you simply glorifying that, which means Sarvahiya Pitari Mumukshubhi. That means all the Mumukshus should undertake this fasting until death. Tat kutah tesham shravanadividhi. If fasting until death is so great, then everybody should do that. Then atma vare shrotavya, mantavya, you know. So that is no scope at all. Tatkudha tesham shravanadividhi. If the fellow is dying, you know, then where is the question of his listening to scriptures, etc.? Iti ashankya sakshadati. So next verse is sakshat vastu vijnane shrutya yatra niyujyate vidvan parihare tatra bhuta hetum prayatnatah. Otherwise, everybody, or instead of even fasting unto death, everybody should go to Prayaga, that's all, or go to Kashi. That is the easiest. You don't even have to fast and die there. So, it is said, Sakshat vastu vijnane shrutya yatra niyujyate vidvan. To however, yatra vidvan sakshat, so shrutya sakshat vastu vijnane niyujyate. So, wherever vidvan or learned person is in fact enjoined to pursue the knowledge, so vastu vijnana niyujyate, so wherever he is in fact commanded or asked to apply himself to vastu vijnanam, the knowledge of the vastu, knowledge of the self. Yatra jnana muddishya shravanadu shrutavyadi shrutya purusho niyujyate. So where Shravana is possible, Vividisha having been obtained now, therefore where Shravanam is possible, then one should not go for anything else. Yatra jnanamuddhishya. So keeping jnana in mind, Shravanado Purushaha Niyujyate. So Purusha, the person or the seeker or the Vividishu, is Niyujyate, is now enjoined or is ordered now to take up the Shravanadi by the Shruti, Shrutavya, Mantavya, Nidhyasatavya. Tatra Samarthaha Sadhana Chatushte Sampannaha Marana Karanam Anashanam Duradeva Tyaje. Parihare Tatra Mruti Hetum Prayatnataha. Then one should give up this Mruti Hetum. That is cause of death, that is fasting into death, must be kept far away. Tatra Samartha, that means one who has the Samarthya. So one who has the capacity or the Yogyata, the qualification to apply himself or herself to Shravanam, then everything else must be given up. Tatra Samartha, Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampanna. So one who is endowed with Sadhana Chatushtaya, Marana Karanam, Anashanam, Duradeva Tyaje, should give up Anashanam, this fasting which is cause of death. That kind of fasting must be given up. He may continue the regular fasting, but this fasting which is cause of death, that means dura devatya yaj, should be given away, given up from a distance, should be kept at a distance. Anashanantaram cha adriyeta, and kama anashanam, that means partaking of the sense objects without dispassionately, so that he should in fact respect. So two kinds of anashana now we are told. One is anashanam or fasting, which involves partaking of the sense objects dispassionately or avoiding any kind of indulgence, So discipline association with sense objects, this is what is meant by anashanam. So that is what then one should resort to and give the other kind of anashanam, which is fasting into death. So anashakena is interpreted two ways. So the first one should then be resorted to. So that's what the verse said. Sakshattu vastu vijnane shrutya yatra niyujyate vidvan. So when vidvan and purusha is samartha, that means one who possesses the qualification to study, then he must only apply himself to study. Parihare tatra mruti hetum. That mruti hetum anashanam parihare. Mruti hetum, the cause of death, that anashanam must be given up. Prayatnataha. What is prayatnataha? And mruti hetum. The tika says, mruti hetum iti visheshanat shravanadi samarthastu maranantam anashanam acharan pratyaveyat tvam padartha veka ityadi smrutihetyarthah. So mruti hetum parityajet. So that kind of anashanam must be given up. That means one should not mortify one's body. Because body is required to do this sadhana. So to the extent that body is required through Shravanam Mananam, to that extent the body also must be taken care of. Not unnecessarily pampered, but must be kept in proper order so that it is available to Shravanam Mananam. Vrutahetum iti visheshanat Shravanadi samarthastu. And therefore, one who has the capacity to do the Shravanam, Maranantam Anashanam Asharan. So even though he is able to listen to the scriptures and Shravana means vichara. When one is capable of doing Shastra vichara, then also ignoring that, one for whatever reason takes up this kind of fasting into death. By some kind of hatagraha, you know, suppose one does that. Pratyaveyat. Then he is in fact transgressing the instruction of the Shruti or the Smruti. Tvam padartha veka ityadi smrutehe. That means when one is capable, then one should apply oneself to the Tvampada Viveka. There is no doubt about that. And then ignoring that, and for whatever fanciful reason, he undertakes the fasting into death, then there is a Pratyavaya. Pratyavaya means one incurs sin actually. One violates. So idea is that in every stage of life, in every state of mind, there is always an appropriate thing that one should do. And therefore, when one mind is ready, appropriate thing is to do the Shastra Vichara, that is the most appropriate thing. And ignoring that, and one because of some fancy takes up this kind of austerities, then That means one is in fact transgressing the order. So pratyaya means transgressing the order, and that will have its consequences, unpleasant consequences. Then the Tika continues, Vedana Vachanadi Shabdanam Karma Paratmuktva Ashana Vishatamaha. So Tamitam Vedana Vachanena. So Vedana Vachana means the recital of the Vedas. So Karma Paratmuktva. So Yajnena Dhanena Tapasa Anashakena. All of this is of the nature of karma. Karma Paratmuktva Ashana Vishatamaha. This also can be interpreted as various ashramas. Vedana Vachanam, Yajna, Dana, Tapaha. All of these can be interpreted as different ashramas. That will be stated here. So Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, these ashramas are also indicated here by these expressions which are chosen by the Shruti. Chaturnamiti. The next verse is, Chaturnam ashramanam va vedan vachanajana shrutyaya grahanam nyayam tad bhutsa prasiddhe. Let us say that, so when Shruti employs this kind of expressions, vedan vachanena, yajnena, danena, tapasa, then chaturnam ashramanam va vedan vachanajana grahanam ya shrutya. The Shruti here implies that all the four ashramas, in fact, all the four ashramas are included here. Grahanam nyayam, we should understand that Shruti means that the people or members of all the four stages of life are qualified for vividisha. Tad bhutsa prasiddhe. That means everybody is qualified for vividisha or desire to know. Which means in whichever ashrama one may be, as long as one performs these karmas enjoined for that ashrama, those karmas will become then the means of vividisha or creating a desire to know. Thus everybody is qualified for vividisha. This is what is the idea here. That's what Mahashrekar also said there. Say the Tika, Vedanu Vachanandi Rupaya Ashrutya Kimi Yasmin Vakye Grahanam Ashramanam iti ashankya taditi. How do you say that? This means that the four ashramas are indicated here. Tad bubhutsa prasiddhe, for accomplishing the bubhutsa or vividisha. Bubhutsa is same as vividisha. Says sarveshabhi ashramanam vyavadhan avyavadhanabhyam pratyek vidishayam adhikarartham tesham grahanam ityartha. Sarveshabhi ashramanam. So people belong to all the ashramas, vyavadhan avyavadhanabhyam, directly or indirectly, immediately or later on. So apparently all the ashramas may not give rise to vividisha right away. But in course of time, the karma will give rise to vividisha. So vyavadhan avyavadhanabhyam pratyek vividishayam adhikarartham tesham grahanam. And so, in short, every karma has the potential of inner purification and therefore giving rise to the vividisha in course of time. That is why it is said here that as far as vividisha is concerned, so ultimately as far as knowledge is concerned, then people belong to all the stages of life. And as Bhashyakara said, people belonging to all the castes also are qualified for vividisha, for creation of the desire for self-knowledge. Kena shabdena kasya ashramasya grahanam. Alright. Which word indicates what ashram, what stage of life? Iti apekshayam madhyanirapatham anusatya vivagamaha. So, when that apeksha is there, so when you say that, these words imply all the four ashramas, which word implies which ashrama? Iti apekshayam madhyanirapatham anusrutya. So following the reading of madhyandina shakha, Vartikara says, see, that is given right there in Tika. Tametam vedanu vachanena brahmacharyena brahmanaha vivirishandi yajnena danena tapasa anashakena tihi patanti. one brahmacharyana is additional there. Tametam vedanuvachanena brahmacharyana. So that is added. Brahmana vividishanti. So vedanuvachanena is brahmacharyana. That is how there is a connection there. So brahmacharyantaiti says Vartikara. Brahmacharyanda vakyena brahmachari parigraha. So tametam vedanuvachanena brahmacharyana. Up to that. So that section, brahmacharyanda vakyena brahmachari parigraha. So that means, so vedanuvachanena brahmacharyana refers to brahmacharyashram. Tapasa tapasascheva yajnena gruhinastatha. Tapasa anashakena. So that is very clear. That the person who is committed to tapas or austerity, that means vanaprastha ashram. So vanaprastha is primarily ashram involving tapascharya, upasana. And then yajnena gruhinastatha, yajnena danena, that is primarily, yajna is definitely performed by gruhastha, and danam also primarily performed by gruhastha. So by that, gruhastha ashram. So vedana vachanena brahmacharya, yajnena danena gruhastha ashram, and tapasa anashakena vanaprastha ashrama. Then tika says tathapi trayanameva ashranameha graha chaturtha ashrama dyoti shabda abhavat tathapi trayanameva ashranameha graha. Still you say all the four ashramas, but the words that are mentioned here seem to only indicate three ashramas. Chaturthashrama dyodi shabda bhavat, that does not seem to be a word here which seems to indicate or which seems to reveal the fourth ashrama. Idi ashinga etamevedi. Then Vartikara says, etamevedi. Acha shraddha anashaka vakyam du sarvarthamidi gamyade. That's interesting. Very shraddha, anyway. So Shraddha Anashaka Vakyam Tu Sarvartha Vidhi Gamyate. So what is the Shraddha anyway? I don't have that path apparently. Shraddha Anashaka Vakyam Tu Sarvartha Vidhi Gamyate. So, my Madhyandini part, I must have Shraddha also, and Anashakena. To Sarvartha Vidhi Gamyate, that is for everybody. So, could be Shraddha Vitto Bhutva. So, that's Sarvartha Vidhi Gamyate. So, Anashakena, that applies to everybody. That's the idea here. Alright. Still only three ashramas involved here included. Where is the fourth ashrama? Then says, etameva vidityvedi parivrajyam ca vakshati. So that's the next. Etameva pravrajyam, etameva vidityva munir bhavati. Etameva pravrajyana lokamichyanta pravrajanti. That is very clear. So etameva pravrajyana lokamichyanta pravrajanti. That vakya definitely talks about sannyasam. Whether that is adhikara for vividisha or after vividisha, that's a good question here. Anyway, etam viditva munir bhavati, etameva pravraya lokamichyanta pravrajanti. I would imagine that pravrajanti is for vividishu already, one who has said. And so that cannot be kept in line with the other, which are meant for vividisha. So yajnena danena tapasa anashakena will create vividisha. Whereas pravraya lokamichyanta pravrajanti is after vividisha. And so, anyway, so chaturnam ashrama adhikarah tad bhutsa prasiddhai. Supposedly all the ashrama, the karma enjoined in all the ashramas give rise to bhutsa. But we would say that the karma enjoined in, because karma are enjoined in three ashramas, and so they give rise to bhutsa, and then the fourth ashrama is for the Vedanta Vichara. Or one takes sannyasa in course of, you know, one's life and follows the name of sannyasi also. Then also they'll give rise to bhubhutsa or vividisha. says then the last verse here, Vedan Vachanadi Shabdanam Ashravishatum Vadata Vividishadvara Mokshopayatum Ashramanam Uktam. Vedan Vachanadi Shabdanam. Otherwise, elsewhere, the interpretation is Tapasa Anashakena. That Anashakena Tapasa is the qualification for a sannyasa. Tapasa by austerities, that is the Vanaprastha. But when that tapas is qualified as Anashakena, that means that maintaining the balance, you know, so that kind of tapasya is for the sannyasi. So that's how all the four ashramas are included there. Anyway, Vedanu Vachanadi Shabdanam Ashram Vishayatvam Vadata. So by the Vartikara who says that this Vedanu Vachana, etc., they all refer to ashramas. Vividishadvara Mokshopayatvam Ashramana Muktam. That means that all the ashramas are the sadhana for moksha through vividisha. That means that if one persuades sve karmani abhiratah, sam siddhim labhate naraha. Svakarma nirata siddhim yathavindati tachrunu. Lord Krishna says, sve sve karmani abhiratah, sam siddhim labhate naraha. So whatever be the karma that falls upon oneself by way of one's caste and ashrama, sam siddhim labhate naraha. So, if one is clear that the purpose of life is in fact spiritual growth, and that the material prosperity is something that is subservient to spiritual prosperity, if that is clear, then every ashrama and every caste is okay. Varna and ashrama are all right. So, varnashrama dharma or any vyavastha, as a matter of fact, any vyavastha anywhere can work, provided there is everybody in that vyavastha functions in a spirit of cooperation or mutual help. That upakarya upakaraka sambandha is there among members of any setup, then alone that setup can work, otherwise it cannot work. And that requires that then one should not be a selfish person, you know, otherwise no vyavastha will work. So therefore, even for the social vyavastha, so for the samaja vyavastha also to work, and the varna and ashrama, this vyavastha is given for the society to function in a family and the society to function in a harmonious way. That will happen when all the members of society have a maturity. That the purpose is to prosper, and inner prosperity is important, and outward prosperity is something that will follow. If this is the understanding of all the people, then everybody will positively work for inner prosperity. And inner prosperity can be gained by the spirit of this cooperation, or upakari upakaraka bhava, which obtains the whole unity, yajna. So then if people belonging to any setup, they follow the spirit of yajna, or offering, then of course the setup is going to work. And that is how people belong to every caste also, will grow to gain that vividisha. Svaka, sve sve karmanya bhirataha, sam siddhim labhate naraha. So person who is committed to or devoted to one's own karma, one's own duty. So there the commitment is to duty rather than what the reward the duty brings. This has always been the idea of this culture, you know, which is a very, very high level of idea. That's a very tall talk, you may say, that a person becomes indifferent to the material gain and one is committed to spiritual gain. It can be there. Depends upon the environment in which one is growing. Right now the environment being what it is, there is a tremendous value only for the material prosperity. Or ego gratification, that's most valuable right now. However, I mean, we can imagine a time when perhaps the spiritual growth may be valued. In which case, spiritual growth will then require my having to abandon in course of time this ego gratification business. But anyway, then the persons belonging to all the castes and all the ashramas are qualified for vividisha, that is for sure. Svakarma nirata siddhim yathavindati tachrunu. Yatah pravrtir bhutanam yena saramidam tatam svakarmanatam abhyarcha siddhim vindati manavaha. And so worshipping the Lord with whatever karma one has in one's share, one attains that siddhi or perfection. That siddhi can be said to be vividisha. Antahakan shuddhi, giving rise to a desire for knowledge. So this is the vision of the scriptures. that the Varnashram Vyavastha is meant to prepare everybody for ultimate goal, namely moksha. So society is geared for moksha, which is a very huge thing anyway, for ordinary people. So ordinary people are just concerned about all this regular mundane stuff, you know, that's all they're concerned about. Most people cannot go beyond that anyway, regardless of Vedanta and no Vedanta. People come ultimately to get some kind of a solace in their own life. That's primarily what people want. This spiritual thing, etc., they always are only for very few people. Those who have that kind of a viveka, that my life is meant for spiritual growth, people just want mundane stuff, even out of Vedanta ultimately, you know. And so this kind of an understanding that life, moksha is the purpose of life, if that is there, of course, there is no question. But that's what the Vedic culture expects out of its people. So when the Varnashrama Vyavastha was in fact recommended, or which may be brought into practice, the idea is that the members of society, members belonging to society, have that maturity, that the purpose of our life is moksha. Dharma, artha, kama are all right, but ultimately dharma is the means and moksha is the end, and artha, kama can follow. If this kind of a great perception of life is there, well, there is no problem at all. Then, of course, everybody will prosper. Moment artha, kama, when they become the primary goal, then dharma and everything has to suffer, then nothing but conflict will come. So basically, the problems of any setup can be dealt with only when the people belonging to setup have the maturity to understand what is the purpose for which we stand, and therefore what is important and what is not important. But here it says, Vividisha dvara mokshopayatum ashramanam uttam. That all the ashramas, brahmacharya, grahastha, vanaprastha, sannyasa. Sannyasa is chaturth ashrama, that's all. All of them, through Vividisha, become the means of moksha. Tatra pramanamaha sarvepi. There the pramanam is saying. Sarvepi kramashastvete sevyamana yathavidi. Yathokta karanam vipram nayanti paramam gatim. That's the pramanam. This must be a verse coming from someplace then. Sarvepi kramashastvede sevyamana yathavidhi. Yathokta karanam vipram nayanti paramam gatim. It must come from some smriti. So sarvepi kramashah tu ete. Kramashah, in course of time. It is not that everybody will get Vividisha right away also. But iha janmani janmantareva, either this birth or in some birth, it is basically devotion to one's own duty. Devotion to one's own duty, which again is brought about by devotion to one's own purpose of life. So it is that devotion which will bring about the antahakara shuddhi and Vividisha in course of time. Yathavidhi sevyamanaha ete sarvepi kramashah yathokta karana vipram paramam gatim nayanti. So sarvepi ete, all of these ashramas, yathavidhi sevyamanaha, when they are sevyamanaha, when they are pursued yathavidhi, in accordance with the vidhi, in accordance with the scriptural direction, then kramashah, in course of time, or in course of stages, yathokta karana vipram paramam gatim nayanti. They paramam gatim nayanti. They lead this vipra, they lead this brahmana, or lead the yathokta kari. So one who follows the injunctions of the scriptures, that is all. That's called yathokta kari. He does whatever the shastras enjoin him to do. So he is also called vipra. Doesn't matter whether he is brahmana or not, but then yathokta kari is a vipra. Nayanti paramam, unless it is meant for vipra alone, I do not know. That verse, it only means all ashramas of a brahmana or all ashramas of all the varna. So Bhashyakara said all the three varnas are equally qualified. So paramam gatim nayanti. Chaturbhihi ashramaihi एभि यथा शास्त्र अनुष्ठितैहि अत्यन्तं क्षेमम् आप्नोति आपस्तम्भोऽप्युभाषत. दिस इज आपस्तम्भ. चतुर्भिः आश्रमैः एभिः यथा शास्त्रम् अनुष्ठितैः. सो अनदर वाक्य इज हियर. यथा शास्त्रम् अनुष्ठितैः एभिः चतुर्भिः आश्रमैः. बाय ऑल दिस फोर आश्रमास विच हैव बीन अनुष्ठितैः, विच हैव बीन पर्स्यूड यथा शास्त्रम् इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द इंजंक्शन द स्क्रिप्चर्स, अत्यंतम क्षेमम् आप्नोति. सो बाय वन अटेन्स अत्यंतम क्षेमम्. द क्षेम शब्देन मोक्षम ग्रहीतुम अत्यंत विशेष अत्यंतम क्षेमम. क्षेम मीन्स श्रेयस, अत्यंतम श्रेयस मीन्स मोक्ष. आप्नोति इति आपस्तंभोपि अभाषत. दिस व्हाट आपस्तंभ आल्सो सेड. आपस्तंभ इज इन प्रोज ऑर्डर, सो इट मे बी दिस इज आपस्तंभ मे हैव सेड इट इन इज इन प्रोज ऑर्डर विच हैज बीन रिटन हियर इन दिस मेट्रिकल फॉर्म आई गेस. Okay, so this is the Vatikara's explanation of kam anashakam anashakam kamam kam anashanam kam anashanam anashakam nitu bhojana nivritti iti. All right, we continue with the page 1286. श्री आनंदगिरी भवतु उपात्तानां वेदान वचनादीना विश्यमाने ज्ञाने विनियोगः. ऑल राइट, भवतु उपात्तानां श्रुत्या उपात्तानां. सो व्हाट एवर द श्रुति हैज टेकन अप, वेदान वचनादीना विश्यमाने ज्ञाने विनियोगः. सो व्हाट एवर द श्रुति हैज स्पेसिफिकली टेकन अप लाइक वेदान वचनम यज्ञेन दानेन तपसा नाशकेन इश्यमाणे ज्ञाने विनियोगः. लेट इट बी नाउ दैट ऑल दैट वी एक्सेप्ट दैट ऑल दीज द कर्मास दैट आर मेंट टू बी परफॉर्म इन ऑल द वेरियस आश्रमास दे लीड टू विविदिशा. सो इश्यमाणे ज्ञाने विनियोगः दे लीड टू विविदिशा देन लीड टू ज्ञानम एंड देन लीड टू मोक्ष. दैट्स द कर्म दैट यू वुड एक्सेप्ट. तथापि कथम सर्वं नित्यं कर्म तत्र विनियुक्तम्. बट Shruti only says yajnena danena tapasa. A few karmas are mentioned here, but you say that this particular statement enjoins, says that the entire Veda has its application in jnanam. That entire karma kanda serves the purpose of jnana kanda, and entire Veda has its application in jnanam. But here it is not the entire Veda that is stated, only a few karmas, yajnena danena tapasa vedana vasanena, that's all that is stated. सो भवतु उपात्तानां वेदान वचनादीना इष्यमाणे ज्ञाने विनियोगः. सो स्पेसिफिकली व्हाट एवर द श्रुति टॉक्स अबाउट वेदान वचनम. नाउ दिस फॉलोइंग भाष्य. सो भाष्यकार सेड यज्ञेन दानेन तपसा अनाशकेन वेदान वचनेन. सो दीस फोर विच आर स्पेसिफिकली मेंशन्ड बाय द श्रुति, विच द श्रुति हैज स्पेसिफिकली टेकन अप यू नो इन दिस स्टेटमेंट, लेट दीस फोर वेदान वचनम यज्ञ दान एंड तप. सो भवतु उपात्तानां वेदान वचनादीनां इष्यमाणे ज्ञाने विनियोगः. सो विविदिशन्ति दैट दिस फोर कर्मास गिव राइज टू विविदिशा, एंड देयरफॉर लेट अस से दैट दिस फोर हैव देयर एप्लीकेशन इन ज्ञानम और द मीन्स ऑफ ज्ञानम थ्रू द विविदिशा. दैट्स ओके. बट योर कंटेंशन इज दैट this statement means that the entire karmakanda has application in jnanam. How does that amount to sapi katham sarvam nityam karma tatra vinyuktam? How do you say that all the nitya karma is meant by the shruti and not just this four? Iti ashankyah vedana vachana iti. So replying this doubt, Bhashyakara says vedana vachana यज्ञदान तपःशब्देन सर्वमेव नित्यं कर्म उपलक्ष्यते. वेदानुवचन यज्ञदान तपः वेदानुवचनेन यज्ञेन दानेन तपसा. सो बाय दीज वर्ड्स सर्वमेव नित्यं कर्म उपलक्ष्यते. बाय उपलक्षण By Lakshana Vritti, we must understand that these trends are all the Nitya Karma. So these are the representatives. So these representatives of total Nitya Karma have been mentioned in Vashruti. We should understand that they represent or stand for entire Nitya Naimittika Karma. Upalakshade. And then Upalakshana Phalamaha. By Lakshana Vritti, that means, you know. So what's the phala? Upalakshana phala. Evamiti. Evam kamya varjitam nityam karma jatam sarvam atma jnanotpatti dvarena moksha sadhanatvam pratipadyate. Evam, in this manner, upatasya upalakshakatve sati. Upatta is what is specifically picked up by the Shruti. Vedana Vachana, Yajna, Dana, Tapasa. Except that they stand for the entire group of Nitya and Naimittika Karma. Then that is so. Evam Sati. When that is so, then Kamya Varjitam. So Evam means Evam Sati. Kamya Varjitam Nityam Karma Jatam. So Nityam Karma Jatam. So the entire host of karma, which are called Nitya Karma, Kamya Varjitam, excluding those karmas which are specifically meant to fulfill desires. Sarvam atma jnanotpatti dvara, all that karma through the dvara, through the gate of atma jnanotpatti, through the gate of creating the atma jnana. Moksha sadhanatvam pratipadyate. So they become the means of moksha. All the nitya nimitta karmas give rise to vividisha, and through that atma jnana, and through that moksha, this is the krama. Then Anandagiri says, pranadya karmanaha mukta hetutve kandadvayasya ekavakyatma visiddhyati pranadya paramparaya. So karmanaha mukta hetutve. So how karma gives rise to vividisha, then it gives rise to jnanam, it gives rise to moksha. So parampara, in this way, pranadya karmanaha mukti hetutve, karma also becomes a hetu for mukti. Then kandadvayasya ekavakyatvam, that means the entire Veda consisting of these two kanda, karma kanda and jnana kanda, all of the Veda has its application of purport only in mukti, that's all. So Veda is moksha shastram. Kamya Varjitam, you must say, except here, excluding the karmas that are meant for fulfilling specific desires. So, Eka Vakya. Then the purport or import of the entire Veda is one alone. Siddhyati, this is what gets established, Evam Karma Iti. Evam karmakandena asya ekavakyata avagatihi. So, evam, footnote number 2, avataranoktatva. So already we read that avataranam. In this manner, karmakandena asya is jnanakandasya ekavakyata avagatihi. Thus we understand that this jnanakanda also has the same import, karma kanda also has the same import as a jnana kanda. The problem comes when we do not accept moksha as the goal, then this system doesn't work. The varnashrama vyavastha, no vyavastha will work. Basically, varnashrama vyavastha also will not work. When artha kama become the goal, or they become the purushartha, then the varnashrama vyavastha does not work. Because artha kama necessarily require a person to compete. Selfishness must be there, as we see in the society. And that is how it is. If you want to get more and more, naturally you must compete. And you must grab. Which means that you must progress, or you must prosper, and you must be ready to prosper at the cost of others. So wherever selfishness is there, there is going to be violence. And where violence is there, no system can function. Only when there is, to whatever extent selfless is there, tasmat sarvagadam brahma nityam yajne pratishtitam. Wherever spirit of Yajna is there, then Brahma is there, then God is there, and then harmony is there, and then the system will work. And so, this Varnashrama Vyavastha has been so much criticized, and even condemned. And there are many people who are convinced that that is the cause of all the ills of the Indian society, the Varnashrama Vyavastha. But no Vyavastha can be the cause of ill, you know. It's a human mind that is the cause of all the ills, which takes up any Vyavastha for, which exploits any Vyavastha for its own ulterior motives, you know. Like communism, you know, it has brought about all the, you know, it has destroyed many, many people. It's not communism. It's the people practicing that, you know, who will take communism, whatever ism they want, and do whatever they want. Somebody can kill 6 million people, you know, 60 lakh people were killed by this, by the Nazis, in the name of dharma, you know, whatever their concept of dharma. Then somebody, look at what your dharma is doing. Dharma doesn't do that. Somebody uses the idea of dharma to do whatever they want to do. And so, anyway, evam karma kandena asya jnana kandasya eka vakyata avagatehi. In this manner alone, we can see how the entire karma kanda also indirectly serves the purpose of jnanam. Jnana kanda directly serves the purpose, directly means karma kanda is indirectly the means of jnanam. Then vakyantaram avatarya vyakaroti. Next vakya then. This is the next one. Etameva viditva munir bhavate. That's the next vakya. So vakyantaram avatarya. Introducing next vakya, Vyakarodi, Vashyakara explains, evamiti. So, etameva viditva munir bhavati, it says in the page 1287, evam yathoktena nyayena etameva atmanam viditva yatha prakashitam munir bhavate mananan munihi yogi bhavate ityarthah. Evam yathoktena nyayena, by the nyaya, by the rule that has been stated, what is it? Anandagiri says, Yajnadi anusthanad vishuddhidvara vidishotpattav kurupadopasarpanam shravanadi chaydi anena kramena. Yajnadi anusthanad vishuddhidvara. So attain that inner purification by the performance of yajna and other enjoined duties. By that is befitting one's own self, that's all. Nowadays, to determine the duties, whatever it is that is befitting to me in any given situation. Vishuddhi dvara, so that brings about that inner purification. Vividisha utpattav, then arises vividisha, the desire to know the self. Guru pada upasarpanam, and then approaching feet of the teacher, saranadicha, and undertaking the shravanam mananam by that krama. Evam yathoktena nyayena, yathoktena kramena. By that karma, by that sequence, by that, in that order. Etameva atmanam viditva. So having gained the knowledge, so etameva atmanam viditva, yathoktena nyayena, yathoktena kramena, so chaturtsu nityanaimiti karma, vividisha, then guru pasadanam, saranam, and gaining knowledge. In this manner, yathoktena nyayena, etameva atmanam viditva. Knowing the Atma as such, what is etameva atmanam viditva? Yatha prakashitam. So that which is, says Anandagiri, yatha prakashitam, moksha prakarane, mantra brahmanabhyam, ukta lakshanam ityarthah. Moksha prakarane, atha akamayamana ityadav, footnote number 3. Atha akamayamana, what is akamaha? Nishkamaha, then atmakamaha, aptakamaha, atmakamaha, akamayamanaha, akamaha, nishkamaha, आप्तकामः आत्मकामः यथा प्रकाशितम् आत्मानं विदित्वा एंड दस नोइंग द आत्मा एज रिवील्ड बाय द उपनिषद्स मुनिर भवति हैविंग नोन द आत्मा वन बिकम्स अ सेज Mananat Munivan becomes a contemplative sage. Here, mananam means contemplation, reflection. That means one becomes then an introvert person. That is, one becomes abide, one gains an abide. Transcendental knowledge. That's what it means here, Muni. So, yatha prakashanam, the Tika said, moksha prakarane. मंत्र ब्राह्मणाभ्याम उक्त लक्षण इत्यर्थ है सो मंत्र ब्राह्मणाभ्याम बाय मंत्र ब्राह्मणादि आत्मा दैट इज सो रिवील सो नित्य शुद्ध बुद्ध मुक्त स्वभाव अनापरम सो व्हाट इज इट अपूर्वम अनापरम इन दिस मैनर द आत्मा दैट इज रिवील सो नोइंग दैट वन बिकम्स मुनि योगी शब्द है जीवन मुक्त विषय योगी भवति आनंद गिरी सेज योगी हियर मीन्स जीवन मुक्त है Ultimately, one becomes Jivan Mukta. Now, etameva viditva munirbhavati, there is eva karadhar. Knowing this alone, one becomes Muni. So, Annagiri says, eva karam vyakaroti. Etameva viditva, only knowing this. So, what's the meaning of the word eva there? Etameva, Bhashyakara says, एतमेव विदित्वा मुनिर्भवति नान्यम् एतमेव विदित्वा मुनिर्भवति न अन्यम् विदित्वा अन्यम् इज व्हाट कर्मादिकम् अनात्मवर्गम् फुटनोट 1 सो एतमेव एव कारय से नोइंग दिस अलोन वन बिकम्स मुनि वन बिकम्स अ सेज नोइंग आत्मा अलोन एंड नॉट दिस कर्म नॉट अनात्मा एंड नॉट कर्मादिकम् अनात्मवर्गम् So the aparavidya or karma or anatma, knowing that one does not become muni, only knowing the atma, one becomes muni. So there muni also means sthitadihi, muni uchyate sthitapragna also. Avadharanam akshipya samadhatte etam eva. There is an emphasis there that knowing atma alone, Akshibai is being questioned. How can you say that? And Samadhanam, the reply also is given here. So question, if this is question, this conclusion. At the same time, the Samadhanam, meaning explanation also is given as to why there is so Nanu Ityadina. Nanu Anyavedanepi Munitvam Syat Katham Avadharyate एतमेव इति ननु वेट अ मिनट अन्य वेदने भी मुनित्वं स्यात् देयर आर मेनी सेजेस इट इज नॉट दैट यू कॉल हिम ओनली अ सेज विद आत्मज्ञानी सो पीपल हु नो आयुर्वेद एंड ज्योतिष शास्त्र एंड अदर शास्त्र आल्सो सो देयर आल्सो ऋषिज देयर आल्सो मुनीज सो देन देयर आर व्याकरणाचार्य आर देयर सो व्याकरण ग्रेट सेजेस हैव बीन देयर And Nyaya, and Vyakarana, and Mimamsa, and many of the Shastras are there. And there are people, great people, who have mastered those scriptures, and have been, they are all great sages. So, Anya Vedanevi Munitvam Syat. So, one can attain the state of being a sage by knowing these other subjects also. Katham Avadharyate Etamevaiti. Then how come the Shruti says that knowing this and excludes everything else? The knowing Atma alone, that one becomes a sage. How does Shruti say that? Then says Bhashyakara, Badham Anyavedanebi Munirbhaved Bhadam Satyam, you're right. That's called Ardhangikara. You know, part of what you say we accept. Bhadam, you're right. Anya Vedanepi Munir Bhavet. One becomes Muni or a sage by knowing other things also. Then says Anandagiri, Evakaras Tarhityatyadyatam. Then give up your Evakara. If by knowing other things also one can become a sage, then don't say that knowing this alone one becomes sage. Give up that this alone part. Then iti asange kintu, then says, so Ardhangikara is there, the second half is not accepted, that is stated here by kintu. So, kintu anyavedane namunirevasyat kintarhi karmi api bhavetsah. So, yeah, you're right. He'll become Muni all right. But kintu anya vedane na muni evasyat, by knowing other things, one will become sage all right, but one will be not merely sage, then other things also will be there along with that munitvam, other things also will be there. What is that? Kim tarhi? So, vedane muni evasyat na muni evasyat. He'll become sage all right, but not only sage. Then what will he become? Karmi api bhavet. He'll be a muni also as well as a karmi also. So, knowing other things, one cannot really become Muni, but one also will remain Karmi. Here, then, says Mahasaya further, Etantu Aupanishadam Purusham Viditva Munirevasyat Natu Karmi अतः असाधारणं मुनित्वं विवक्षितं अस्य इति अवधारयति एतमेवेति एतन्तु औपनिषदं पुरुषं विदित्वा मुनि एव स्यात् न तु कर्मी. However, knowing this औपनिषद पुरुष is a karta, abhokta, actionless. So, knowing the action is Atma as one's own self, one becomes actionless and no more karmi. That thing. So, knowing Anatma, one can become a sage, alright. But since Anatma always involves action, therefore, one also will remain. At least, even if one does not do anything, there will definitely be this idea that I am a karta bhokta. The idea is that the notion of kartrutva, bhoktrutva cannot be removed by other forms of knowledge. And therefore, even when one gains a great mastery in other forms of knowledge, and that way does become a contemplative person, still, his notion that I am a karta or bhokta, that I am a doer and enjoyer, that notion cannot go away. And therefore, when we say karmi, he may not appear to do a lot of things. But definitely he entertains the idea, he entertains the notion that I am a doer. In that sense, that's what Bhashyakara means. That only by knowing the Upanishad Purusha, the Atma, then alone one can discover the Self as a Karta, and then alone one can really become free from all the karma. Because freedom from karma can never be deliverable upadhi. Even a person who says, Naiva Kinchit Karomiti, I do not do anything, he also appears to do everything. Pashyan, Shrunvan, Sprashan, Jigran, Nashnan, Gachan, all of that is doing. And then while doing, he says, I don't do anything. That means that the karma sannyasa or karma tyaga is not something at the level of upadhi, it is something at the level of understanding only. Sarva karmani manasa sannyasya aste sukham vashe. So manasa viveka buddhya, by the viveka buddhi, one renounces all the actions. By what is the viveka buddhi? Knowing that I do not perform any action at all. Navadvare pure dehi nevikurvan nakarayan, and thus he dwells happily. In this city of nine gates, neither doing anything nor making anyone do. And that can only be by knowledge. Because not doing anything at all is not possible for all the time. Even the body is kept stationary, still, then also mind can function. Even the mind is kept still, that also you cannot keep your mind still all the time. Something has to be there. Some activity has to be there, in which case again some karma will be there. Akarmani karma yah pashyet, And therefore, one who believes that I am thinking, even that also becomes a karma. So unless one gains a knowledge of the Atma that is actionless, there is no way that one can become actionless. Because actionless, no one can become. There cannot be such a thing as actionlessness at the level of Prakriti, because it is the nature of Prakriti of the matter always to do, to undergo change. Even a muni also doesn't know anything at the level of body, his body will undergo some change. The mind, so things have to change. And then if I think that I am the body, I will feel that I have changed. That being the case, actionlessness can never be achieved. It is something to be known. So Bhashyakara says that only by gaining, knowing the Upanishad of Purusha, that one can become actionless. So Jivan Mukta, that's called Mukta. As long as I am doing something, I cannot be Mukta. Because when I am doing something, I am always going to be accountable for what I do. Even if I do something virtuous, then also I am accountable by having to go through the results of the virtuous deeds. And if I did something vicious, I am going to be accountable for that. So whenever I do anything, I become accountable. An accountable person is not free. Who did this? I did it. Why did you do that? That's it. And so one who does, who is accountable, he will always be questioned. So people always have this, you know. Some people are always subject to being criticized. The simple reason is very simple. Because they do things, you know. So whenever you do things, you're always open to everybody's remarks and criticism. When you don't do anything, of course that's fine, then you can be free from criticism also. But whenever anybody does, you speak anything, you can always find something, you know, because you speak. Not that you should speak in an irresponsible manner, not that you should do things in a sloppy manner, etc. But whenever somebody does something, there's always likelihood. Because some blemish is always going to be there. Sarvarambhaya doshena dhumena agni rivavrutaha, just as fire, however it is, you know, some kind of smoke, some element of smoke is bound to be there. So Lord Krishna also says, whenever you do something, some dosha is always going to be there. Because some violence will be there. That is, life is full of violence. All you can do is to minimize the violence. So when you even talk, some violence, any talk, somebody is going to be hurt anyway. Something is going to be stated. Somebody is going to be said to be true. That means something is declared as wrong or false. Moment you declare something as false, that is violence. Because ultimately, nothing can be totally false anyway. When you take any side, whenever you say anything, there is always going to be some violence. Because even when you praise somebody, somebody gets condemned anyway. Because when you praise something, oh, you spoke very well today, that means every day I am not speaking well, you know. That means the other speeches are in some way or other condemned. And that being the case, one cannot be free. The idea is jivan mukta. One cannot be as long as there is an idea of kartrutva. As long as there is this notion or the complex that I am a doer, so long there is always, here it says, nainam krita krute tapataha. So this person is not in any way scorched by or tormented by what is done and what is not done, or done knowingly or unknowingly. So, atah kalyanam akaravamiti, atah papam akaravamiti. All of these things do not bother him because he doesn't do them. It is not the fellow does punya pava and then is not bothered about them. That's a different matter. You know, that is the gross irresponsibility. That's a different matter. But he doesn't do any punya pava, therefore they do not bother him. So that is how here Bhashyakara's point is that unless one comes to know oneself as actionless, there is no way that one can become actionless. And as long as action is performed, so long the consequence of action is going to be there. Whether it is good or bad, some consequences will be there and one will be accountable for that consequence. And therefore, one has to take a bath or do whatever is required in order to be accountable to that consequence. And so, samagram praviliyate. Then samagram meaning, agra means karma phala. Along with karma phala, the karma praviliyate. Yajnaya acharata karma samagram praviliyate. Gata sangasya muktasya jnana vastida chetasaha. Only one is free from all sangha, and therefore mukta, and therefore one whose mind abides in the knowledge of self. So whatever that person performs spontaneously is done by in the spirit of yajna. in the spirit of dedication to totality, because there is no sense of individuality. I mean, this is a huge thing. This goal that the scriptures present, moksha, I don't know whether people understand, but it's something that is very, it's just most glorious, but something that is most difficult. Knowledge means what? Knowing that, I mean, the sense of individuality is completely resolved. That means, well, there is a total identification with totality. Now that means there is no pakshapada of any kind. There is no such thing as aham mama. And so, what is it? Vihaya kama anyasarvan pumam charat nispruha nirmamo nirahankara sa shantim adhigacchati. So when can one gain shanti? As long as mamatvam or ahankaratvam is there, shanti cannot be. Stronger they are, more ashanti is going to be there, and less strong they are, more shanti will be there. Basta shanti madhigacchati, there cannot be shanti as long as ahankara and mamakara are there. Thus, to become totally free from the idea of a sense of individuality, that means then identification with the totality. That means there is no raga and no dvesha at all of any kind. Now, this is not an ordinary thing. So, always talk of knowledge, knowledge, that's all right. But this is what knowledge amounts to. And so this is how you can see, that's a real sage who, for whom Vasudeva Kutumbakam, for whom the entire universe becomes his family. And then he becomes the Sarvabhutatma Bhutatma Kurvannapin Lipyate. He discovers himself as a self of all. That means there is no raga dvesha left at all. Now, so that is the concept of moksha here. Yeah? And so one who discovers the self to be actionless alone can be actionless. And that alone can be free. So therefore, the word Muni, as Anandagiri said, Muni here stands for, Yogi Bhashyaka said, Yogi stands for Jivan Mukta. Edantu Aupanishnam Purusham Viditva Muni Heva Syat Natu Karmi. Ataha. So footnote 1, Atma Vidaha Karmitva Bhavat. Since the self, knower of the self, is not karmic, is free from the notion of the doership, therefore, asadharanam. Sis footnote number 2, natu sarvashrama sadharanam, asadharanam munitvam. Because every ashrama can have munitvam. Everybody can be a sage, you know, in his own right, the brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, or chatushashrami. But this asadharanam munitvam, this munitvam is of a different class. So, yes, knowing karma also one can become muni, knowing Veda also one can become muni, knowing upasana, one can become a sage. But asadharana munitvam, the munitvam or the sageness, this is something of a different order. Vivakshitam asya pratyak yathatma vidaha. So, one who knows the self, and the self is, for that person, the munitvam, being muni of the sage, is of a different order. Idi avadharayati etamevaiti. See, inasmuch as Shruti wants to say that the munitvam or the sageness that this person enjoys of a different class, therefore Shruti says etameva viditva, knowing this alone one becomes muni. So etameva muni eva bhavati, that also is meant here. Muni eva bhavati natu karmi. In that case, eva kara is taken with muni, etam viditva, muni eva bhavati natu karmi. That way also Mahashri can explain. See, Dhananagiri, katham atma vidopi munitvam asadharanam. How do you say that the munitvam, the contemplativeness of the scarcity, I guess, that's how, from sage, asadharanam. How come he enjoys being a sage, being the state of being a sage, which is something different, you know? So etasmin, Bhashyakara says, etasmin hi vidite kena kampashe ityevam kriya asambhavat mananameva syat. Etasmin Upanishad Purushe hi vidite. So when this Purusha, the Paramatma, revealed by the Upanishad. And how the Upanishad reveal the Atma? as the self of all. So, yastu sarvani bhutani atmanyavanu pasyati sarvabhuteshu chatmanam tato na vijugupsate. So, atma or purusha, that is the Upanishad, is the atma of all. So, itasminhi Upanishad purushe vidite. Kenakam pasyeti devam. Then, kenakam pasyet, kenakam shrunuyat, vijaniyat. What will one see? With what? The idea is that the seer, seen and the seeing, when all of them have resolved into the self, then there is no seer separate from the seeing. So even when, that means that, even when the act of seeing goes on, still, as far as a wise person is concerned, he is not seeing someone who is totally different from I. He is seeing myself in myself. So, saiva buddhyate vedan iti vedanta nischayah. Kalpetyatmanatmanam atma devasva maya. The atma deva has by his own maya projected the whole world, and he alone keeps on perceiving it. And therefore, even though the perception can be there, the idea of the divided division that the perception normally involves, the wise person is free from that. So perception is there. But whenever perception takes place, I am the perceiver and something else is perceived, that division is there. Well, at least the wise person is free from that idea of division. Because that division is purely mental. Perception is all right. That's part of vyavahara. But the interpretation, that what is being perceived is different from the perceiver, is interpretation obtaining at the level of the mind. So that is where the change takes place. Kenikam pasyeti devam kriya asambhava. And therefore, kriya or the karma, in meaning duality. So duality in the primary sense not being there, the karma also in the primary sense is not being there. So, jnana, what is it? Jnanagnidagdha karmanam tamahuhu panditam buddhaha. So the wise people call him pandita, whose karmas are all burnt in the fire of knowledge. So kriya asambhavat mananam evasyat. Now what can he do? Kriya asambhavat. He can't do anything. Knowing himself is actionless, he cannot do anything. Therefore, mananam, all he can do, all he can remain is abiding in this knowledge. And therefore, so Bhashyakara says, he cannot but be the muni, because he has no option of be remaining karmi anymore. Having discovered the Upanishad Purusha as the actionless self, there is no option of becoming remaining karmi. Therefore, muni eva syat, that also is equally appropriate. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutrabhashya krutau vande bhagavantau punah punah Ishvaro guru ratmevi murti bheda vibhagine Vyoma vadvyapta dehaya dakshina murtaye namah Om shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.
Tametam Vedam Vachanena Brahmana Vidishante Yajnena Danena Tapasana Shakena Etameva Viditva Mudir Bhavade Etameva Pravrajana Lokamichyantah Pravrajante Etat dhasma vai tat purve vidvam safpajanna kamayante Kim praja krishyamo yesham noe vatmayan lokaite Te hasma putra ishanaya asya vitra ishanaya asya loka ishanaya asya vyutthaya Asa viksha chaliyan charande Yashyeva putra ishanaya asya vitra ishanaya Yavitta Ishana Sa Lokeshana Yavitta Ishana Sa Lokeshana उवेक्षेते एषण एव भवतः शेषनेतनेत्यात्मा अदृश्यो न हि दृश्यते अशीर्यो न हि शीर्यते असङ्गो न हि सज्यते असितो न व्यसते नरिष्यते एतमुहै वैतेन तरतैते अतः पापमकरवमिते अतः कल्याणमकरवमिते उभे उहै वैष एते तरते नैनं कृता कृते तपतः భాష్యకారా కామెంటెడ్ పాన్ తమేతం వేదాను వచనైన బ్రాహ్మణ విదిశంతి యజ్ఞేన దానైన తపస అనాశకైన ఆన్ ద పేజ్ 186 వేదాను వచన యజ్ఞ దాన తప శబ్దేన సర్వమేవ నిత్యం కర్మ ఉపలక్ష్యతే ఏతమేవ వేదాను వచనైన బ్రాహ్మణ విదిశంతి యజ్ఞేన దానైన తపస అనాశకైన సో వేదాను వచనైన యజ్ఞేన దానైన తపస అనాశకైన బై దిస్ ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్ ఫాలోడ్ బై ఆల్ దిస్ వర్డ్స్ సర్వమేవ నిత్యం కర్మ ఉపలక్ష్యతే They represent all the nitya karma, all the karma, the duties that are enjoined upon a person. So vividishanti, that means that all this nitya karma are all the daily and incidental obligatory duties, vividishanti, they become means for creating vividisha or the desire for knowledge. Evam kam yavarjitam nityam karma jatam saram atma jnanat patti dvarena moksha sadhanatvam patipadyate. Thus yajnena dhanena tapasa vividishanti, these become, so they are in the instrumental case. యజ్ఞేన బాయ యజ్ఞ బాయ దాన బాయ తపశ్చర్య వివిదిషంతి దే సీక్ టు నో దట్ మీన్స్ ద డిజైర్ టు నో అకర్స్ సో దీస్ ఆర్ సెయిడ్ ఇన్ ద మీన్స్ ఫోర్ ది అకరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ డిజైర్ ఫర్ నాలెడ్జ్ దట్ మీన్స్ ఆల్ ద డైలీ అండ్ ద ఇన్సిడెంటల్ ఆబ్లిగేటరీ డ్యూటీస్ దట్ ఆర్ ఎంజాయ్డ్ బై ఎ పర్సన్ దే బికమ్ ద మీన్స్ ఫర్ క్రియేటింగ్ వివిదిష ఆర్ ద డిజైర్ ఫర్ నాలెడ్జ్ ఏవం కామ్యవర్జితం నిత్యం కర్మజాతం సర్వం ఆత్మ జ్ఞానోత్పత్తి ద్వారేణ మోక్ష సాధనత్వం ప్రతిపద్యతే ఇన్ దిస్ మేనర్ నిత్యం కర్మజాతం The whole host of nitya karma or the daily obligatory duties. Kamya varjitam. In other words, the Brahmana section of the Vedas have not only the obligatory duties but also the actions or rituals to fulfill specific desires. Kamya karma. So again, Vashyakara here says, so excluding all those rituals which have been specifically
stated for fulfillment of desires, excluding them, rest of the whole host of karma which are enjoined by the Vedas, saram atma jnanotpatti dvarena మోక్ష సాధనత్వం ప్రతిపద్యతే ఆల్ దట్ కర్మ మోక్ష సాధనత్వం ప్రతిపద్యతే ఆల్ ది కర్మ అటైన్స్ ద స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ బీయింగ్ ద మీన్స్ ఆఫ్ మోక్ష సో కర్మ ఆల్సో దెన్ దిస్ వే బికమ్స్ ద మీన్స్ ఆఫ్ మోక్ష జ్ఞానోత్పత్తి ద్వారేణ త్రూ ద్వారా త్రూ ద మీన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్రియేషన్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ వెల్ లెట్ అస్ సే దట్ ది కర్మ వెన్ పర్ఫార్మ్ ప్రాపర్లీ బికమ్ ద మీన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్రియేటింగ్ ద డిజైర్ ఫర్ నాలెడ్జ్ అండ్ ఫుల్ఫిల్ ద డిజైర్ వన్ undertakes appropriate means, namely Shravanam, Mananam, Nidhyasanam, and that's how Jnanotpatti, the knowledge, takes place, and that is how Moksha Sanatvam, and knowledge being the means of Moksha, Karma thus indirectly becomes the means of Moksha. Evam Karma Kandena Asya Aikya Aikya Ekavakyata Avagatihi Thus, karmakandena. Thus, it is clear that even the Upanishad, or what we call the Jnana Kanda also, has the same import as the karma, or the karmakanda has the same import as Jnana Kanda. So, this is basically Bhashyakara's assertion through this passage, that this passage is meant to show that the entire Veda has its application in knowledge, in self-knowledge, an entire Veda including the Karmakanda also. So it is shown that way. That this particular Vakya, Tametam Vedanu Vachanena, is the particular one that makes it very clear that Tapasa, Yajnena, Dhanena, Tapasa, all of these Nitya Karmas are meant for Vividisha, the desire to know, and that's how Jnanam, and that's how Moksha. So moksha and through self-knowledge is the import of the entire Vedas. Then commenting upon this, etameva viditva munir bhavati, next sentence, evam yathoktena nyayena etameva atmanam viditva yatha prakashitam munirbhavati. Evam yathoktena nyayena. So by the rule that has been stated, yajnyade anusthanad vishuddhi dvara vividishotpattav. So guru padopasarpanam shramanadi chaiti anena kramena. Yajnyade anusthanad vishuddhi dvara. So antahakana shuddhi, or the inner purification that takes place by the performance of these duties. Tadvara vividishotpattav. The vividisha desire to know takes place because of that. Guru padopasarpanam. Then one takes the refuge of the teacher. Sharvanadicha. And of course, then perform the Sharvanam, Mananam, Nidhyasanam, iti anena kramena, in this sequence. Yathoktin nayana, this kramena, through this sequence. Etameva atmanam viditva munirbhavati. Knowing this self alone, one becomes a muni, one becomes a sage, one becomes a contemplative sage. Yatha prakashitam atmanam viditva. Moksha prakarane yatha prakashitam. So atma, which is thus revealed in the moksha prakarana, savayesha mahanaja atmayo vijnaname praneshu. So this way, knowing atma such as that, munir bhavati. Knowing the self, one becomes muni, one becomes a sage, a contemplative sage. Vashyakara says, mananat munihi, because he becomes a contemplative one. Vashyakara wants to make a point that he no more remains an active one. He gets transformed into a contemplative one. Yogi bhavati, in fact, jivan muktaha bhavati, he becomes liberated even while living, and therefore, he becomes free from the need to perform any action at the level of body, mind, or speech, or anything. And therefore, all that he does is nothing but dwells upon the self. That's how he becomes a contemplative sage. He really retires, you can say. He really becomes nivrutta. Then, etam eva viditva munir bhavati. Knowing this atma alone, he becomes a sage. Knowing this alone. So that evakara is there. Etameva viditva munirbhavati na anyam. Knowing atma alone does it become a muni, and not knowing something else. And the question is asked, nanu anya vedanebi munitvam syat katham avadharyate etameva iti. Why do you say, or why do you insist that knowing the self alone that he becomes contemplative? Knowing anything a person can become contemplative. Anyavedanevi munitvam syat. One can become a contemplative person by knowing any other aspect of knowledge. Katham avadharyate etameva. How come the Shruti insists or emphasizes that knowing atma alone that one becomes contemplative sage? The reply is given badham. Anyavedanevi munir bhaved. Yes, you can say that by knowing something else. That is by knowing physics, chemistry, or whatever it is, or karmakanda, knowing any other branch of knowledge also, that one can become a contemplative person. Kintu anya vedane na munirevasyat kintarhi karmi api bhavet saha. The only difference is that by knowing other things, that is by gaining knowledge of something other than atma, that one may become contemplative, all right. But then one also becomes a karmi, one also becomes active, because every other form of knowledge is a means of action. This is only knowledge which is a means of retirement, renunciation. Every other knowledge, in fact, so by knowing the non-self, when we come to know the non-self, that is something different from myself. Either I know it to be something desirable or something undesirable. So when I know something as desirable, then also there is an impulse to do something because it is desirable. Therefore, I want to acquire it and enjoy it. When I know something is undesirable, then also there is an impulse to act because I must get rid of it. So this is why Bhashyakara says, knowing anatma, the non-self. Knowledge may require him to think about it. So he can become a thinking person, a contemplative person. For on account of what he knows, what is prompted within him is karma, is an impulse to do something, not an impulse to withdraw, that's all. Intarhi karmi api bhavet saha, he may become muni, all right, but he also becomes karmi. Etam tu aupanishadam purusham viditva muni yavsyat natu karmi. On the other hand, knowing this aupanishadam purusham, knowing the purusha, the paramatma, the self, that is revealed or unfolded or expounded by Upanishad, one can only become muni, one can only become a sage, contemplative sage, and not a karmi. Idea is that knowing this purusha, the self, one becomes free from every desire and therefore becomes free from need to do anything, and that's how one becomes, then remains only contemplative sage. Nadu karmi. And therefore, every impulse for karma or the action is automatically eliminated, and therefore, person only remains a muni. We are on the page 1288. Ataha asadharanam munitvam vivakshitam asyeti avadharayati etam evayati. And thus, this evakar is commented upon etam eva viditva munirbhavati. Etam viditva eva. Etam eva viditva, knowing this self alone. Ataha atma vidaha karmitva bhavat. Since the knower of the self cannot be a karmi, that's all. This is a tremendous assertion. Once you come to know the self, there cannot be any impulse to do anything, that's all. Now all of this of course has to be stated only on account of the Mimamsakad insisting that yavat jivam agnihotram juhuya, that one must perform the agnihotra, which means one must perform all the daily and incidental obligated duties as long as one is alive. This is their assertion. Therefore, this assertion becomes necessary for their benefit. All we can say is that. So, atma vidaha karmitva bhavat, since the knower of the self cannot anymore remain a karmi, cannot anymore remain an active person, that he cannot be a go-getter anymore, that's all we can say. Asadharanam munitvam. Nadu sarva ashrama sadharanam. Everybody can be contemplative. A brahmachari also can be muni or a contemplative one. A grihastha also can be contemplative one. But they will contemplate upon what they were to do. So brahmachari is supposed to study the Vedas, and therefore his contemplation would be of the nature of that nature which would enable that person to perform his studies well. But a grihastha is the one who is to perform various duties, so he will also contemplate. Except that his contemplation would be to determine what are the means to perform such duties. That means his contemplation would be upon karma. What karma is to perform, how is to be performed, this is what one has to contemplate. So that way, munitvam or the mananam, reflection or contemplation is required in every stage of life. So sarva ashrama sadharanam munitvam. In every ashrama, every stage of life, contemplation is required. Except that in the first three stages of life, the contemplation would be always the nature of, so always centered upon karma. Ataha asadharana munitvam. But for this one who has known the self now, his munitvam, his contemplation is of a different class. Not the contemplation of those other persons, but contemplation of a different nature or different class. Asadharanam munitvam vivakshidamasya. Asya pratyek yathatma vidaha. I think this is what we have to read, isn't it? Anyway, so let us read on the page 1288, let us read this sentence on the first line. Ataha asadharanam munitvam vivakshitam asya iti avadharayati etameveti. अतः अस्य असाधारण मुनित्वम्। And therefore the contemplativeness of this person, of the knower of the self, is asadharanam. He is of a different class, different nature. That is not the contemplativeness that occurs in the other three stages of life. We are centered upon karma. This person's contemplativeness is centered upon the self. Vivakshitam. This is a vivaksha. That is a desire to say on the part of the Shruti. So this is what the Shruti desires to say when the Shruti uses the word eva. Iti astya pratyajñātātmavidah. So one who knows the self as the self is, that this person enjoys a munitvam or a contemplativeness of a class different from the contemplativeness enjoyed by the other three stages of life. To emphasize that, this is the Shruti uses the word eva. Avadharayati etamevaiti, therefore that evakara is meant to convey this. Atmavedavi karmitvam syadichet na. So the reply was, there cannot be karmitvam when the self is known. This Anandagiri on the page 1287, the previous page and last line. Alright, so you say that this knower of the self enjoys a munitvam or sageness or sagacity, whatever, which is different from that enjoyed by the other three stages of life. Katham atmavedopi munitvam asadharanam. How do you say? So what's the reason why you say that this knower of the self has this sageness, you know, which is different, contemplativeness different than Bhashyakar etasminiti. एतस्मिन् हि विदिते केन कं पश्येत् इति एवं क्रिया असंभवात् मननम् एव स्यात् एतस्मिन् हि विदिते फुटनोट नंबर 4 औपनिषद पुरुषे विदिते सो इन दिस औपनिषद पुरुष This Purusha means the conscious being, the Paramatma, the full and complete being that is thus revealed or expounded by the Upanishad, for which Upanishad is only Pramana. Etasmin hi vidite, when this Purusha or the Paramatma is known, what's the nature of that knowledge? What does the knowledge involve? Kena kampasyedi. What will one see through what? What will one speak through what? That means that knowing this Purusha, who is one without a second. So that knowledge completely dissolves all the duality of the knower and the known and the knowing. That very duality itself gets dissolved, knowing fully well that the truth of the knower and the known and the knowing, the truth of all these three is one, and that I am. Thus knowing the Adhishthana, the substrate of all of this, the very vyavahara of one talking to someone different from oneself, or one listening to someone different from oneself, that vyavahara goes away because the very idea of something different from oneself itself goes away. That means this self becomes all-inclusive. It becomes all-pervasive or all-inclusive. Therefore, in his concept of I, nothing remains excluded. And there cannot be karma within one's own self. I cannot talk to myself or I cannot listen to myself for any vyavahara such as that it involves always the three factors, the knower, the known and the knowing, the doer, the done and the doing and so forth. And when all this triputi, the triad itself gets resolved into self, then there cannot be any vyavahara. There cannot be karma. The idea is that karma requires this duality of the knower and the known. And when that very duality gets resolved in the wake of the knowledge, then there is no scope for karma itself. That means the very basis for karma or the action, which basis is on the duality, that itself gets resolved, and therefore there is no scope for karma or the action at all. Etasmin hi vidite kena kam pashyeti, what will one see through what? Iti evam kriya asambhavat, and therefore the kriya action becomes impossible. Because action requires a duality, that duality not being there anymore for this wise person, there cannot be action in the real sense anyway. Even if he seems to perform the action, it can only be merely an appearance of action, but not action in the real sense. Therefore, mananam eva syat. So, his kind of mananam, contemplativeness, is that there, it is a contemplativeness totally exclusive of any action. Because in this knowledge, all the scope for the action itself has been completely resolved. Other people will have mananam reflection or reflectiveness, but that reflectiveness will always involve karma and duality. Whereas here, it is reflectiveness exclusive of karma. Therefore, asadharanam munitvam, his munitvam or his contemplativeness is of a different class. Then say the Anandagiri, itascha atma vidaha na karmitvamedi. Itascha, for this further reason, atma vidaha, for the knower of the self, na karmitvam, there cannot be doership. There cannot be doership for the knower of the self for this further reason. Paschakaraita skinchaiti. Kincha etameva atmanam svam lokamichyantaha prarthayantaha pravrajanaha pravrajanashilaha pravrajanti prakarshena vrajanti sarvani karmani sanyasyanti ityarthaha. So now Vashyakara comments upon the further statement here, etameva pravrajana lokamichyantaha pravrajanti etameva lokamichyantaha etameva atma lokamichyantaha. So, desiring this loka, desiring this world or the realm that is the self. So, desiring to the self, pravrajanaha pravrajanti. So, ichchantaha, desiring the self, the renunciates take to the life of wandering. That's all. Pravrajanaha pravrajanti. So, those who have discovered a total dispassion. So, thus those who desire only the self, so those who desire the loka, the world which is a self, because other worlds are also there. The bhuhu, bhuvaha, svaha, all these different worlds are there. So desire to know those worlds is one thing, and desire to know the world of the nature of atma is another thing. So vividishanti, inasmuch as, so etameva viditva munir bhavati, and also since there is now the vividisha, the desire to know, etameva lokamichyantaha, desiring this world of the Atma, pravrajanti, there has to be renunciation. So Vashyakara says that the contemplativeness of the self-knower is of a different nature, and also the knowledge of the self will automatically make a person renunciate. So this is the further reason why